Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophonet and welcome back to The Witcher 3. Under that much difficulty, we're still in the Hearts of Stone DLC and we're back at the Garen Estate where we first met Olgierd von Everrek, and it appears the Garen Estate is on fire. The Wild Ones are standing outside, so we're gonna take a look at what the problem here is. Jesus, look at that. Holy shit. What happened here? Wow. It's completely going up in smoke.
Well, look who's here. The Witcher with a stick up his ass.
What's new?
Got a growth on your platter there. You catch some kind of a fiery pox?
Could say so.
He's also wearing a fiery sword.
That? All right. You know how it is. Feast drags on with plenty of dancing, merrymaking, rough play. We got a bit carried away, truth be told.
Plain to see. Where's Olgierd?
Damned if I know. Must be somewhere hereabouts.
No! Please! I beg you!
Shut your trap!
And what is this about?
Leave me be!
Shut up!
I ain't with yous! Drank with yous! Fought beside yous! And you'd kill me now! I'm one of yous!
Why would you do that, indeed?
Not no more, you ain't.
What's he guilty of?
What the fuck's it to you? Not your concern, mate.
Calm down, let's talk.
Whoa, nerves a little raw? Why?
You death! Get the fuck out of here, freak!
All I want is to know what exactly's going on here.
Well, you're not gonna know! Sod off!
I'll leave as soon as you tell me.
Aren't They're starting to get really aggressive.
Ataman said to kill him.
Got your answer. Happy? Now piss off. We've work to do.
Okay. Let him go or face my wrath. Do what you will, not my concern. Well, it is not my concern. I don't really know these people. But, let's talk about this.
Wait. I know Olgierd wants him dead. Still don't know why, though.
Just what the fuck is it to you, anyhow?
Nothing really. Just curious.
Cocksucker violated our chivalric code. Just one penalty for that. Death.
Oh yeah, that's the same guy that slapped the ass of that woman.
What is this row?
That maid.
Are you not done with it?
That maid.
My ears wither from the screams.
And there we go.
Ah, Geralt.
Flop.
As you've returned, might I assume you've cleared the sewers?
We did, asshole.
Or have you not been there?
You killed my father!
Okay. Holy shit.
You lie, Horson!
That man killed him. Alone. Unbeknownst to me. Out of fury, for your father refused his hospitality. For this brutal violation,
there's a sword through your chest.
He was summarily executed himself. Anything else I might do for you? Take her away.
I think Master Mirror's curse just made the man immortal. Can you pull that out for me, please? Yeah, okay. Oh, there we go.
No.
That kind of explains his scars. This suddenly became a lot more Beric Dondarrion from Game of Thrones than it was before.
Really necessary, that whole show?
Ah, show? Come now. A man must display some madness from time to time. Helps him feel alive.
Can agree with that to some limits.
On your face.
So, recognize the mark, yeah, indeed. We're gonna wait with that. So first, the immortal thingy.
You're immortal?
Depends on your understanding of the term. Indeed, I cannot be killed. But it's
yeah,
not
that's
at all what folk
immortal.
Imagine. Not dying does not mean eternally living your life to the full.
So it's a curse?
A curse? No, wouldn't call it that. I'll put it this way. You must be careful what you wish for, lest your wish be granted. For there are consequences.
Not
there
sure.
There are a lot of movies and books that go.
So you take wild risks.
Deeper into that subject.
Sensations. There comes a point you've done it all, and all seem boring and monotonous. The trick's to plough through that moment. Go further. Reach beyond what's known as possible.
Okay. So far, nothing wrong with that, and he kinda executed that man because he killed the father of that woman. The woman that stabbed him through the chest for some reason. Recognize the mark?
Know what this is?
I cannot be certain, but I've my suspicions. That's a dangerous man you've chosen to deal with, Witcher.
I'm assuming that curse you've got there came from that same man.
Kill
my reward.
Beast in the sewers.
Congratulations are in order then. Your reward. You're also welcome to take what you wish from the manor house. If anyone's left uncharred, that is.
Yeah. We kinda got that already.
Was it a tough fight?
I sliced its gut open, and it turned into a man. You know that would happen?
Of course he did. He'd never have dragged
him. Oh, there he is. Hello, Gaunter.
Come to cast aspersions?
No. I've come to collect a debt.
You know you first must...
Grant you three requests, by proxy. I present to you my champion, Geralt of Rivia.
So is the first wish granted then already? That true, you knew the Toad was a prince.
That true? You know the Toad was a cursed prince?
He didn't just know. He brought about the curse himself. Did he not mention that bit? Well then. Allow me to tell it. Quite the gripping story. Olgierd once loved a beautiful maiden named Iris. Yet, her parents chose to offer her hand to the Crown Prince of Ophir. Olgierd grew to hate the poor sot. At first, he wished to kill him. Then decided this would be too simple. So, instead, he condemned the prince to a base life in a toad's bloated corpus. Yet he grew bored of watching him suffer and decided to end it. By your hand.
Remind me, Odin. Who is to fulfill my last three requests?
My assistant, Geralt.
Then be gone. I don't wish to look at your face any longer than I must.
Okay, then. That's rather interesting. So Olgierd cursed the Ophiri prince to keep him away from the woman he loved. Makes him a lot more agreeable.
My men are preparing to depart.
Relatable, that was the word I was looking for. Okay. Seems like a private spat to me, rather not get involved. I don't think we have a choice. You turned the prince into a toad, we know that already. You knowingly put me in danger. Maybe that's a question to ask.
Could have told me the truth about the toad, having a bit of fun at my expense.
I simply wanted the beast dead. I could not know you would respond to the notice. Pure coincidence. Yeah.
Why are we looking underneath the horses?
A witcher answered the call. I thought it right. It's what you lot are trained to do.
Might have been able to lift the curse.
Perhaps. Perhaps not. Then again, why bother?
He was a human being.
That bloody Ethere mutt was no human. His kind does not deserve to live.
Okay then, what are your three requests?
Guess I gotta pop the question directly. What do I need to do for you?
Let me think.
What do you... What can't you do yourself?
Over our heads. Perhaps we should start with that. Bring me the house of Maximilian Borsodi.
Okay.
His house?
So surprised. But why? I must live somewhere, mustn't I? What's the meaning of this? Second leave of your senses? You mean to mount a filthy horse? Out of my sight, wretch! Know what Vladimir would do to you if he saw?
Aye.
Vladimir.
My brother.
A filthy horse?
There were times he himself stank like foot wrappings 3 days old. But his mount always looked fit for a parade. Oh, none rival Vladimir at feasting, carousing. Sadly, he's been celebrating less of late. You must find him and show him the time of his life. My second request.
Fine, seems easy enough. And the third?
Complete those two. Then we shall speak of the third.
Why do I have a feeling he will never ask me that last request? Because that would mean the end of his life, probably. Any helpful hints?
Any hints? where I should go, how I might start?
You must be mad. I've no intention to make things easier for you.
Yeah, fair enough. And where will we find you after we've completed your requests?
With those two, where will I find you?
I cannot know, as my band has planned some diversions. But let us say at the Alchemy Inn, in Oxenfurt.
Fine. See you there.
Yeah, see you there indeed.
The brother shouldn't be too hard, but the house? How am I supposed to bring him a house?
Actually, the opposite. I wouldn't worry about the house. The brother will be the tough bit.
Okay, hello Gaunter again. Nice of you to wait for me.
You waited for me. Nice of you.
I could hardly abandon my proxy to the whims of fate.
Thought I have to fulfill Olgierd's wishes myself.
So states the contract. Yet, nowhere does it forbid me from providing help. And something
sounds like a great plan.
You'll need quite a bit to complete the first two tasks.
Okay. I'm rather curious about the house, though.
Borsodi's house. No idea how I'm supposed to bring him that.
The only Borsodi I know of around here runs an auction house in Oxenfurt.
Heard of it. My swords almost got auctioned off there once. Auction was held in Novigrad, though it was a while past.
They must have relocated. You just might get an opportunity to ask them why.
Fine, I'll go there. Then what?
How should I know? Perhaps you'll get inspired once you're there.
Again, very vague.
Plenty of coin. I have a feeling it could come in handy.
Okay, we have plenty of coin. And where's the brother?
Olgierd's brother. Why do you think he'll be tough?
I'm afraid he's dead. Has been for years.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Never agreed to necromancy.
Necromancy is hardly your only option for reviving a soul. An old-fashioned ritual, a blood summoning. That's what you need.
That's like choosing between pestilence and the plague. Besides, I'd need the blood of the summoned.
Blood? True. Of the summoned? Not necessarily.
Is Olgierd's blood enough, then?
Where do you get this?
Geralt.
Von Everick blood.
Geralt, aren't you the curious one?
Of course we're curious.
Assume it to be Von Everick blood and get on with it.
Okay.
Where'll I find this Vladimir?
Geralt. I cannot do everything for you. Use your head.
A crypt,
Von
probably.
Von are well known in these parts. You must have met someone who's heard of the family. The charming redhead, for instance. The medic. You know the one.
Yeah, Shawnee. Okay. Here we go, then.
Guess it's high time I got to work.
A bit more enthusiasm, Witcher. You know, you just might enjoy yourself.
We just might indeed.
Wait. Say I need help. Where'll I find you?
I shall find you.
And he's gone again.
Good luck, Geralt.
Thanks, man. Thanks. He still is a genie in a bottle, isn't he? Talk to Shawnee about the Von Everick family crypt. And then probably the other thing. Get to the auction to get that house. So I'm gonna assume the house is up for auction and that we need to buy it right away. Let's see about the quest. Give me a second. Something I'm gonna do first. There's a new mechanic in the game called rune words and the like. And I might want to learn more about that by visiting the rune rite. It was level 32, so I couldn't do that before, so let's see about the rune rite. So see you guys there in a minute. So enchanting startup costs. We're at the upper mill. And it seems like there's someone who might help me here. This merchant. It's an Ophiri merchant. Weirdly enough.
You're a long way from Ophir.
A long way and with dangerous fraught. But in our homeland they say, in a risk. There is honor.
Okay, got a ring to it. Not true in my experience, though. Face plenty of risks. Honor, not so much.
Because risk issues from intent. Important is this intent. The long passage I brave to admire the unknown and bring glory to myself and my liege. The world we must explore. Virgin lands discover. New knowledge garner among our brothers than to spread. For is there in life a beauty greater than to admire the new? to stand in awe of the never-ending creation of the world.
That mean I've landed in a camp of explorers and philosophers?
Indeed.
It sounds interesting, though.
To observe, knowledge to exchange, and goods, naturally, to trade.
Let's talk about those that interesting knowledge. Willing to tell me about your homeland? Let's start with that.
I'd be glad to hear some tales about it if you've got the time.
If time you have. For of my home I could speak until your ears withered and your legs failed you. What here they call Ophir, in truth, is many diverse polities and peoples. A land it is of vast steppes, mountains forbidding, lakes clear as crystal, and wild lands untouched.
They should make a
land
game about that.
Empires, kingdoms at their peak, and tribes that know no monarchs, yet remember in myth a time when the world was young.
You call any of these lands home?
Yes. A town with towers to make Nilfgaard weep with envy. Of philosophers, doctors, mathematicians, and mages and enclave. But about these last you should, my friend, interrogate, for one among them is he, a runewright.
I'll make it a point to talk to him.
So you're not the guy we need to talk to. Well, thank you for
Take
the information, though.
Go, and in the world glory, its never-ending creation be praised. Farewell.
Okay. Visit. I thought he said there was another runewright. Wait.
It is to see you again. Quite the pleasure.
Fine horse you've got there.
Quite the mount you've got.
Ah, yes. A loyal friend I have in Babietza, and she is wiser than many a man. Countless races we have won together.
So, an explorer and a jockey in one.
From where I come, small children ride. And not a gathering ease by a horse race not crowned.
I'm not gonna horse race you right now. I wouldn't mind a look at your wares, though.
What did you bring from Ophir? Mind if I have a look?
I'm gonna take a quick look to see if there's anything of interest in his inventory. 55, can I compare that to what I'm using right now? Zarakanian blinders are equipped, so that's better. 100. So that's nothing new. Gontoro Dim Darkness Gwent card. Buy. Francesca Findabear. Let's buy that as well. And Eridin. Let's buy all of that. Ophiri Saber Crafting Diagram. And that's about as interesting as it goes. Because the crossbow is weaker than what I'm carrying. And there's lead. I don't know what lead does, though. But thanks.
Our craftsman's goods, you see worth in them?
Quite a bit, I'd say.
Okay. Looks pretty.
These are nothing compared to what I could offer had I not lost my prize diagrams.
How'd you lose them?
To thieves. In our travels, I and my companions surprised attacked by local ruffians were.
I sense a side quest incoming.
I bemoan not so much as I do one of my comrades. Killed in the violence.
Maybe I can help out with that.
See if I can't find your diagrams. Recover them for you.
These instructions, when followed, produce items worthy of a king.
And that certainly sounds interesting.
Tell me where you were attacked, remember?
A crossroads, not far. Forgive me. For this area, I know poorly. Detailed directions I cannot provide. North of the spot stood a residence, near ruin.
Should be able to find it.
So thanks, man. I'll keep you posted if I can find your diagrams anywhere.
Take care now.
Go, and in the world glory, its never-ending creation be praised. Farewell.
Farewell, friend. So the rune rite must be from Ophir's distant shores. That's the rune rite. Here we go.
Greetings.
Greetings, and praise the world in its never-ending creation.
Don't take this the wrong way, but honestly, the world doesn't deserve much praise.
Nordlings. Disagreeable always. Faces crinkled, soured, ready to quibble to death even a simple greeting. But my tongue now has soured, while you for trade have come. Sadly, I can forge for you nothing. My belongings, tools inclusive, all lost.
Okay. And what is it exactly your trade?
Your or mage.
What does a runewright do?
Has no word to fit my trade. A scholar and artisan I am. Part craftsman, part mage. Gematria, runecraft. Familiar to you are these words?
No. Runecraft seems pretty self-explanatory, though.
True, though my craft further ventures. Runes and glyphs I first make, then arrange into powerful magic words. Great practical applications as my art. For rune stones properly forged in a sword set so as to form a magic word, the blade more power grant than runestones set haphazardly.
Interesting.
Such words too can of glyphs be made and set in armor.
Okay, so by arranging glyphs and runestones in a certain order, we can create more powerful enchantments. That's probably what that is about. So let me recover what you lost.
Listen, folks sometimes hire me to solve their problems. Even retrieved a missing item or two in my time.
For me, this you cannot do. I sailed upon a great ship. It sank, and my instruments took to the sea's dark depths.
Buying replacements not an option?
Of my own design, they were. Specially forged. A fortune it cost to make them. And all the coin that with me I had brought lies now in the murky abyss with my instruments.
We might be able to help each other out, because I have quite a bit of coin left.
Given that, I'd be happy to help you out. What do you say I get you the coin you need? Could pay me back in runes and glyphs.
Is it certain, your offer? A great sum I require. Tools of great expense I need to make even the simplest glyph. I make no mention of the more advanced or master crafted.
Rest easy. Got a feeling this will be a good investment.
5,000. I have plenty more where that came from, because I'm at about 30,000 right now, I think. So, got some coin for you, but maybe let's talk a bit more about your craft first.
Way you talk about your art, sound more like a man of faith than scholarship.
Faith and scholarship for you lie in conflict. Yet in my land, holy men are scholars. Wisdom, their source of esteem.
The Afiri believe in any gods?
From region to region, this varies. Raised I was to believe in one god, the world. Symbols are God's speech. To study his words is to draw nearer to him.
Symbols, meaning runes and glyphs.
Mere signs are these. An attempt by men imperfect to describe the world. Yet a magic to them there is, and from God all magic issues. When runes I create, when into words I arrange them, this is prayer. And when into swords I enchant them, that is my benediction.
So that's really interesting how they combine wisdom and religion, well, knowledge and religion together to study what's going on around them. So, but what brought you to our lands then?
Can't help but wonder what brings you to our lands.
A simple thing. For knowledge, a thirst.
Of course.
All he could, my mentor had taught me. The tongues of our lands I'd learned. Of all our plants and animals, I know the names.
Risk that long a journey to learn new words?
A life of plenty I would have lived at home, for the beauty and import of my art are respected. But such a life would be unfulfilled. Great and diverse is the world, for a pace continues its creation. A riddle it is, which through symbols speaks. The world's tongue to learn I wish, the signs by which it speaks to discover, their syntax to master, through this to learn the principles of creation.
So a man who had everything, that left everything behind and lost everything in the sea, to learn more. Interesting. Really cool man. So, I got some coin for you, Dad.
Got some coin on me. Is enough?
Start, it is.
Costly.
That's a big start.
Yet the costs do not end with coin. Need I shall also a jade stone of size substantial.
Seriously?
See what I can do.
Seriously? God damn it. Quality has its price. Find a pickaxe. Okay, are we going minecrafting? Enchanting startup costs complete, but I might want to see if I can't quickly take care of that pickaxe here.
Oh!
God damn it. Q. Acquire a hunk of jade for the Ophiri rune rite.
Small jade deposits northeast of Novigrad. I'll okay. Try my luck there.
So let's see you in Novigrad in a second then. So I traveled back to the village of Yantra. We checked out before. To see if we can't find any of those jade deposits around here in the woods. Because I think we're pretty close to one. And then we can use that pickaxe to try and get it out. That's probably what we're looking for. Is this it? Oh, look at that.
Not much jade here. Need to keep looking.
It'll probably be the furthest one away. Should spare me the trouble and get there immediately, but see you guys there. So there's a cave here with the Andrega. Oh shit, those are not Andrega. Those are frickin' straight up spiders. Oh shit! That was just on time. Okay, why are they staying over there?
Damn, you're ugly.
Come on, hit me. Frickin' spiders, those are new. I've never seen those before, so let's loot them all. Bent key and a yellowed letter. Mate, if you're reading this letter means you're a free man, knew Drakenborg could never break you. I feel damn bad it was you they fingered back then. Fate's a bitch at times, ain't she? But you're a made man now. I hid your part of the loot in that cave they wouldn't let us play in when we were young. Was full of the massive spiders then, but not a sign of the critters now. Hunters claim they've migrated elsewhere, not enough to eat here. So they won't be coming back anytime soon, so it's safe. But the bad memories do a great job keeping out nosy hayseeds, making it the ideal hiding spot for loot. The chest is buried in the second part of the cave, get it, and you'll be a rich man, and can drink and wench till the end of your days. See you later, you know where. I will bathe in wine and live in luxury AD. The Drakenborg Redemption. Well, it sounds like that should be right over here then. I'm gonna reapply that insectoid oil just in case. Can't really walk fast in this place, can I? Jade!
Now to extract some.
Oh yeah, here we go. So that's what I needed. Hopefully I can get a big enough chunk out of that rock. So the rune rite can have what he needs. Okay, so take the hunk of jade to the Ephiri rune rite. But now, of course, I want to see if I can't find that treasure. Holy shit! Holy shit! They just trapped me. Damn. Spiders are annoying. Really annoying. So I'm quickly going to check out the rest of the cave and hopefully find some of that treasure in the process. Because the loot was said to be buried in the second part of the cave, and I'm supposing that this is the second part of that cave. Holy shit, that's a big one. Okay, I'm really getting goosebumps over here. Shit. Jesus Christ, this thing is fast. Probably should... Jesus, mother... Holy shit! This thing is aggressive. Holy shit! There we go. Got it. Okay! That was a naughty spider. Very naughty spider. What's this? Ooh, 456 florins. That was a big loot. The Drakenborg redemption complete. So I'm gonna go back to the Ofiri rune ride, and I'll see you guys there in a second. Still having the shivers of because of those spiders, but we're back at the rune ride, and he seems to have moved to behind the mill. Oh, there he is. He bought his equipment. Look at that.
Made good use of my coin by the look of things.
The return to my craft. Know you not the pleasure it brings. I thank you.
You're welcome.
Don't mention it. How's the work going?
Several lesser runes I've forged already. Practice, you see. Yet I sadden in thinking the tools and ingredients I possess are not fit to create better.
Got lucky. Found you some jade. Here.
Thank you, I do. If you to gaze wish at my handiwork, to do so I invite you.
Well, Rune Ride can enhance your items by fitting them with rune words and glyph words. These endow them with new powerful traits. To enchant an item, navigate to the Rune Ride panel. Okay. 10,000's got the funds for advanced tools. I have the coin, but I know I need coin for that quests near the auctioner as well. 10,000 got the funds for advanced tools. Well, we have.
Brought you more coin. Put it towards better equipment.
Thanks in the thousands. Too kind you are to me, truly.
Your work's worth the coin.
And what did that...
Good to see.
Buy us.
Commissioned have I tools.
Ooh, look at that.
A fitting set from Novigrad crafters. Many arms and legs they charged, but renew my work in earnest I now can. New runes, glyphs, and diagrams created I have. An eye you should cast. Find one to your liking, perchance.
So, nothing holding you back now.
From making master-crafted runes, you mean? Much more coin I will need to do so, sadly.
But we won't do that yet. We need 15,000, apparently. So, I'd like you to enhance some gear for me. Let's see how this
craft
works.
Craft something for me, would you?
Okay, so you can enchant items to fit them with rune words or glyph words. These cannot be used simultaneously with runes or glyphs. When you enchant an item, any runes or glyphs it is currently fitted with will be destroyed. Items that can be embedded with rune words and glyph words and thus enchanted can appear here. Only items possessing 3 enchantment slots can be enhanced. Okay, this is the list of rune words, description of the selected enhancements, and you have them at various levels. Okay, so we have superior wolven armor, but for some reason we miss a few glyphs to do that. So we'll start out with the swords then. Severance increases the range of whirl by 1.1 yards and rend by 1.9 yards. We don't have those skills, so each fatal blow dealt restores 25% of your stamina. Fatal blows dealt with your sword give 0.1 to 0.25 adrenaline points. Armor, stable, and grindstone bonuses never expire. Huh. That's interesting. So that's technically a permanent 25% boost then. Implication. Once they reach their maximum level, adrenaline points steadily decline until they reach zero. During this time, vitality and stamina regeneration are accelerated and toxicity declines more quickly. Okay. Any food consumed regenerates 100% more vitality, but everything tastes like pyrogis. Don't know what that is. I want to take a try with preservation though. And there we go. Preservation enchantment level 1. And do that with the Wolven Steel Sword as well. Fatal blows dealt with your sword give 0.1 to 0.25. But I'm going to use preservation as well. Fancy. And I can even add sockets with this guy. Okay. Thank you.
Thanks. So long.
So now if I go to a grindstone or a workbench, I can immediately keep that effect forever. So that's the enchanting quests. So I'm gonna take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I really appreciate any support you can give me. Thank you guys again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or stream. Goodbye.